Hello friends, my name is Russian Badger, and it is time to talk about Rush. Alright, too many of you have been asking for too long for my opinion on this game mode, because you guys know that I started with it. It's my bread and butter from Bad Company 1, and it's always been my favy for the longest time. So, I will definitely discuss that and tell you what I generally think, because I think it's definitely something that you want to hear about. Number 2, I'd like to start off by saying a few things before I get into that. So, I want to thank you very much, number one, for buying me a brand new streaming PC yesterday. You guys donated something like $820 to the live stream. So basically the way it works is, if I play and live stream from the same PC, it's like, Badger, why are you playing on a potato? I can't even see that many frames though. Why don't you try a celery stick? If you stream and play on the same PC, there's such a performance hit that my quality goes down and your quality that you're seeing on the live stream is both horrible. But now that you guys have bought me this brand new external streaming PC, I can probably give you like 720p or 1080p at 60 frames per second instead of like, I don't know, 22 and a half rounded down and lowered quality like it is now. So I want to thank you very much for that. And number 2, I found out that Hannah is a real person, and it's actually like Hannah. You guys know the Hannah from the campaign, alright? Annoying Hannah, I think we all know who I'm talking about. Wrecker, the elevator. Wrecker, get that door. Wrecker, my socks, they need to be changed. Pay my car insurance. Just every single time, I thought it was gonna be a case like, you guys remember Haggard from Bad Company 1? I have a cousin that has a beautiful voice, but a face like a can of dog food. That's what I thought the case was. I thought Hannah was gonna be this, oh yeah, sure, she has a beautiful voice, but then she's really ugly in real life. But no, man. Her name is something like Jessica Val, something like that. She looks the exact same, all right? Literally like the exact same as she does in the game, and it blew my mind that she existed like that. Like, just the thought that the voice actress for that Hannah that was that kind of quality was not like extremely hideous or some kind of a lagoon creature, it really surprised me. So I will leave her Twitter down in the description if you want to go say, like, I don't know, I heart opening doors for you, or let me get that elevator for you, or your car insurance receipt is in the mail. I don't, whatever you want, I'll just leave her down in the description so you can go follow her, because I'm sure that's going to be pretty interesting. So, beyond that, let's talk about Rush for the remainder of this video. And something that you are going to notice, which I find to be pretty game-breaking, it's like, Dice, you catfish, dude. Can I have hit markers, please? That would be really, really nice if I could get hit markers. Now, it's on and off. So, there I got hit markers, but then it's this rock, by the way, bro. It is so comfy. It's, the comfiness of this rock, this whole little, like, concrete slab establishment that I've somehow found, like stumbled upon, it's outrageously comfy. If you can use that in Rush, you should definitely try it. It's wonderful. I got no-scoped by this guy. It's Arcan Tigers. I don't know if he's some kind of tiger trainer, what specifically he is, but in terms of Rush, here is my general opinion. I love Rush. I still love it. You guys know that I started out with Bad Company 1. You know, in Bad Company 1 on the PS3 back in those days, they didn't even have Conquest for the first few months of the launch. And I realized that Conquest has been the basis of every single game in the Battlefield franchise, except for the Bad Company series, kind of. But I remember, like, Conquest came out later on in Bad Company 1. Upon the game's launch, what I played for the longest time was strictly Rush, because there was no Conquest. And that's something that I've grown to love. So, I still think it has the potential to be extremely fun, like it has been in previous games in Battlefield 4, but I think currently it is not being executed because of the server ticket count, man. It's like, oh, come on. And this was kind of a weird situation. I missed the first time, but I'm not going to miss the second man. But this whole room right here is going to get a whole lot hammy and a little bit more awkward the next time I roll around here. But essentially, I think currently 64 players is the most fun. 48 to 64 players is personally my favorite. I think 32 players is boring. It's not enough for the rough scale and the size of these Battlefield 4 maps. But the 75 player ticket count just makes me want to cry. Alright? It seriously makes me want to break down and weep. Like, if you have an issue, here's a tissue. I need to stop crying. And I thought I was gonna, you know, be really sly, jump off the roof, and it's kind of like, I have a tank inside of the shopping mall. I don't know the way the Chinese shopping malls, maybe that's kind of just the way it works in China. I don't know, and I really don't know. But That's not the best idea when trying to get a base with only 75 tickets. I mean, I know 32 players on a team, that's just over having the ability for everybody to die twice. These games are so extremely short, it's just the realistic chances that you're going to be able to march down and get a prolonged period of time or like a real solid shot at getting both MCONs with 75 tickets with 32 versus 32 is just not high enough. And I need server administrators and owners to understand this. Please just give us, I'm going to say 150 to 175 tickets and I will be happy. Even 200. If you err on the side of too many tickets, or not too many, but a larger number of tickets as to a smaller number, I'm still fine with that. And this was kind of awful. Come on, Carl. Why aren't you giving me hit markers? This is just goofy. And I think in here I get something like 9 or 10 kills in a row. It gets pretty outrageous because they have a hard time seeing me. But come on, Dice. I'm not even getting hit markers. Not a single hit marker, yet I'm killing all these guys. This is very, very silly. And I know I didn't kill anybody there. But look, I'm not getting hit markers on any of these. Yet I'm still... Obviously, it still pops up in the kill feed. No hit markers is, yeah, there's a prime example. Both guys, not a single hit marker. And it's not, I wouldn't call it game breaking, but it's extremely hindersome when I'm trying to conserve ammo with a gun that has this kind of rate of fire. It's just annoying. So I'd like to say that overall, I guess I'll discuss this in the future because this rush game was so short because there's only 75 tickets. But I think overall, 64 players and 48 players is what rush is. The conditions for the most fun in Battlefield 4, I just think so many servers are hindered by 75 tickets. Come on, man. Come on, bro, Cookie. Just give me like 150 to 200 and I will be fine. I still love Rush so much because I don't think I'll ever get it away. There will never be a game mode in any other game that ever creates more fun than the whole Bad Company 1, Bad Company 2, up to now in terms of Rush. It's just... The whole game mode is too much fun. I've been playing it for too much long I majored in English, blah blah blah, but I've been playing it for too long to ever separate from it, so I just want to see it fixed with higher ticket counts and the maps to be improved slightly, but I'll get to that later in a future video. So I want to thank you guys very much for watching. I will see you guys next time. Auf Wiedersehen und bis bald und later.
Oh!